Hi Harpers, I'm Tiffany Schaefer from TiffanyHarpAndSong.com, and welcome to Tune Tutor, where we learn traditional tunes the traditional way, by ear. And today we're going to be learning a Scottish march called Atholl Highlanders, and we will be in the key, or the mode, of A Mixolydian. So today you're going to need to set your levers as if you're playing in the key of D, so F and C sharps, but we're going to play as though we're in the key of A. So it's in A with an unusual G natural. This summer is very special on Tune Tutor because not only in May are we learning a march, but in June we'll be learning a Strathspey, and in July we'll be learning a reel. And at the end of that, I'm going to do a video about putting sets together, and you can put all three of these tunes together in a set. To hear what this tune and arrangement, Atholl Highlanders, sounds like, you can click right up here in the cards or down in the video description for the playthrough video. Otherwise, this video is going to teach you how to play this tune by ear, step by step, and you can learn and memorize a tune this way whether or not you have the sheet music. But if you're someone who likes sheet music, you can find my arrangement of this, also linked below in the description, and there are two ways you could get it. You should also check below in the description because there you will find links to video tutorials for the arrangement of this tune, and those are available exclusively for Patreon members. Plus, it's a great way to support this channel if you find value in it. Make sure your F and C levers are up, everything else natural, and let's get started. All right, so this march has four parts, A, B, C, and D. But I'm not going to teach you any of those right now. I'm going to teach you the ending because it is the same on all four parts. So once you learn this, you have quite a leg up on the tune. So to play the ending of all four of these parts, you're going to start with your second finger on E, your thumb on A, the high one. Going to be a fourth apart, and we're going to do a snap. If you want to hear about snaps, you can watch my ornamentation and articulation video. I'll put a link up in the cards. But we're just going to play a quick. Those two notes quickly together. Make sure they're not too separate, and they're not too close, as if they're one. Somewhere in between those two. And I think of the bottom note here as being a little stronger. That's the whole ending we're going to learn. So after you've done that snap, you're going to replace your second finger on E, your thumb is going to go to F, and what we're going to do is play E, F, replace the second finger on E before you play the F, and we're just going to slowly get all four fingers down, all the way down to C. Let's put those together. Make sure you have that snappy rhythm in there. Da, 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 da. One more time. Now, as you play that C with your fourth finger, what I do is bring my thumb right before I play that C onto the D above it. And then you're just going to place two and three on B and A, skip that C. And that is a crab shape. For those of you who don't know about shapes, I will link Carol's videos down below. They're very helpful. Let's play all of that together. We're going to do a snap from E to A, replace on EF, all the way down to C, thumb on D, and crab. And all together, real slow. One, two, one. Great. So get used to that. Once you have that down, you have got the ending for every single part of this four-part tune. So let's go ahead and learn the A parts. So one that sounds like this. Okay. So we're just going to start with the triad, and I use fingers 1, 2, and 3 in the beginning, pretty much only the first time. I think it's easier to switch to 1, 2, 4 after that, but we'll get there. Let's play this triad with 1, 2, 3, and we're going to start with two E's, and then another complete triad. So here's that bit again. Okay, after we've done that, those two triads, What I do that second time, I take my third finger off that A. Right before it, you want to stick your second finger onto the B right above it so that you can climb up. And you're back to E with your thumb. So let's try that again. One is right back to E. So let's do that all together. One, two, three, one, two, three. Okay, as soon as we get back to that E, we're gonna play it. This time though, we're not gonna do one, two, three, we're gonna do one, two, four. And number three is just gonna hang down there out of the way. We don't want him up here like this, making our hand tense. Just out of use. Tuck him away, right? Used to how that feels. The reason we're doing that is because of the fingering. It's going to go 4, 3, 2, 1, but we'll do that in a second. Let's just play it from the beginning here. One, one, two, four. Now you want to sneak finger 3, 2, and one onto B, C, D. As soon as we get done with that triad, here it is. Actually, right before your fourth finger leaves that A. Sneak at least these two guys on, at least 3 and 2, and then you can get one there before he's ready. So let's just do that funny shape again. 1, 2, 4, sneak these guys back on. 1, 2, 4. And then, we're just, from there, we're gonna go exactly the way you have them stacked. 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's play that funny shape all together with 1, 2, 4. 1, 1, 2, 4. 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. All together from the beginning so far. 1, 2. 3, 4. One, one, two, four. 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Great. Okay, you're almost there. After that, we're gonna do the same kind of tune as in the very, very beginning, but we're still gonna stick with, just go ahead and stick with 1, 2, 4 here. Another two E's. And now again, 4, 3, 2, 1. This time, your second finger is gonna sneak up to E and do that ending we learned. So let's back up and do the last round of triads. 1, 2, 4, and we'll go right into the ending. Two E's.
1, 2, 4. 1, 2, 4, 3, 2, 1,
cross under 2. Great. Let's play the whole A part together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let's look at an ornament you can put in here. You don't have to, but you can. So from the very, very beginning. Is one I like to do. Just when you're doing that middle bit, where you have your third finger on B, and then C, D. 3, 2, 1. And then you can take another D. Just an extra D right before you get to that C. And it's a very light extra D. And very quick right before it. You can also learn a little more about those in my ornamentation and articulation video. Again, it was linked up in the cards. I'm sure you can find it. Okay. So let's try that little ornament again. One, two, three, four. There's where it goes. There we go, that was a little clearer. All right, let's learn the B part. The B part is going to be another bunch of triads. So what we're doing here is just an upward A triad, two of them. Now the trick here is, while you're playing this, before you lift your thumb off that E, don't do it until you have your third finger back and ready to play the next triad. So in slow-mo, here it is. Right? Now, before we play that E the second time, our third finger is going to go to B because we're going to do a B triad. And then again, third finger is going to go to B before you leave that F. So let's do those two together. Two A triads and two B triads. One, two, three, four, five, six. How'd you do with replacing? Let's try it again, and this time, as we leave that second F, we're going to put our third finger back on the A for another set of A triads. Okay, here we go. B, D, F, B, D, F, A, C, E, A, C, E. Now, before you leave this E, get your third finger under that B again, and your second finger under the C, and we're going to play that same middle bit we had before. And again, you can leave the ornament in if you like. Okay. Let's try that again, all together. After that, I'm going to show you first, after that little middle bit, we're just going to do another 3-2-1 on A. And another one on B. Sorry, another two, and another two on B. Now here's where you bring in the ending. So let's go through that slowly from the beginning of the B part. One, two, three, four, five, six, two. That was too fast. Let's do that again. We're gonna do two rounds of A triad and two rounds of B. One, two, three, four, five, six. Back to A. Middle part. Four, three, two, one. Two more B's. Ending. You might notice there in the ending, I did another little cut ornament. Right here, I did an extra F. There's another spot you can put one if you like. If not, leave them out, no worries. All right, let's learn the C part. The C part is my favorite. We're gonna start with this E and this A, like we have for the ending. But it's not gonna be quite so snappy this time. They're gonna be a little more separated. And then you're going to want to get your third, second, third, and fourth finger onto E, D, C. And we're just going to go back and forth like that a little bit. We're going to start with E, A, two E's, and then D, C. And then we're going to start straight back to the A. Two E's, D, C. Straight back to the A, two E's, D, C. So let's put all that together. You're only gonna start with the E the first time. Okay, so we do that a whole three times. Then we have the middle bit that we already learned. You already know that. Then we're gonna go straight back up to A. Two E's. A. Two E's. And then the ending. So easy. Let's put all that together for the C part. One, two, three, four, five, six. Start with E. Two E's. C, D. Make sure as you're coming off that C, come back to this A with your thumb right before you come off of the C. Two E's, C, D, A. Two E's, C, D, middle. A. Two E's, C, D, A. Two E's, C, D, end. Great. Here's another ornament you can throw in the C part, if you like. I think it's actually a little easier than doing a double E with your second finger. This actually eliminates that. So you would just play your E and A, and in between these two E's that you have in a row, grab another A right on top of that E. So it sounds like this. And that A is very light and very quick. So just something else you can throw in. Now let's play the D part. Let's learn this. This is the most difficult one in the whole thing. If you, this is a bit too much for you, just go ahead and do you can just play the C, A, C, A. What I have in the fingering here for my patrons when I have, I actually gave them a few extra measures of some easier adaptions this time. And what I have for fingering there is one, because this thing is a little easier. One, two, one, three. One, two, one, three. One, two, one, three. One, two, one, three. And we can learn it that way. You could also just go back and forth, one, two, one, two. What I'm doing for the easier adaptation is C, A, C, A, D, B, D, B, C, A, C, A, B, G, B, G, C, A, C, A, D, B, D, B, and then the end. Now everyone plays written on the sheet music. There's a reason I have this funky fingering, and that is because here's what it actually sounds like, or the way I play it anyway. Now the reason I have that weird fingering is because if you do this and you're trying to play fast and loud, especially with other instruments, 1-2-1-2-1-2, which is easy to default to, and you'll even see that I kind of defaulted to it accidentally in my performance video of this, is it does tend to get pretty tense, especially if you're trying to play loud, especially if you're trying to play with other people. So here's the weird fingering. Let's learn it. We have one and three on C and A, and we're just kind of gonna go one, three, two, one. And that's the pattern we'll use a lot. One, three, two, one. So let's get used to that. One, three, two, one. As you're playing one and three, make sure that two is not up here like this. All right, that's just no good for anybody. We're just gonna keep him down, out of the way until we're ready for him. And I will try to put two on the C before my three leaves A. At least get him around there. So just get used to that. Let's go through the whole fingering slowly here. One, three, two, one, three, two. Now this three, two is on A and C. and that one's gonna go to D. And we're gonna play between this B third, B and D. 1, 3, 2, 1. A couple ways you could do this. The way I have it in the sheet music is 3, 1, and then back to the A, C. C, right there. So that 2, 3, 2, 1, right there. That's a little confusing, so let's do it again from the beginning. 1, 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1 on D. 3, 2, 1. 3, 1, 2. 3, 2, 1. 3, 1, 2 on B now. Because we're going to go to B and G. B, 2. And then 3's on G. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1 back to C. So let's just do that line again. A little bit faster. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. 3, 1, 2. 3, 2, 1. 3, 1, 2. 3, 2, 1. And 3, 2, 1. Right. I lost my place a little bit there. All right. Another way you could do this would be. To put your thumb back up here on D and slide it down to the C. So I'll do that again just so you can see it. So that could work as well. When you do a thumb slide, you don't really close the thumb, you just slam it into the string below it. D to C. Right, like that. So that's another option. Let's finish this out. After we have done the B and G, we're at 2, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. We're back here. 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, and finally we're at the ending. Have mercy. Let's try it again. Let's do the whole D part. I'll do it the way the fingering's written. At least we'll try. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The other thing we need to remember is to keep these little rhythms snappy. So we're not going to play it like this. I mean, you could, but the way it's written, and to be a little more Scottish and snappy, is right, so that first note is just a tad longer. So just to get that rhythm in your head. Now what you would do is you would play the A part, play that twice through. The B part, play that twice through. Same for the C part. Same for the D part. You play each of those parts completely twice through, one after the other. And then if you wanted to make it even longer, you can play it from the beginning again and play each of them twice more. But that is the melody for Atholl Highlanders. Congratulations. Thank you for learning this tune with me. If you liked it, please leave it a thumbs up so I know. or consider leaving me a comment. Those two things really help me out and help this video get noticed by YouTube. If you learn this tune and you feel like sharing your version, I would love to hear it. You can email me, link in the description, or you can tag me on Instagram or Facebook at Tiffany Harp and Song. Don't forget to subscribe over here for more free videos, and click here to be taken to Patreon, where you can check out rewards like extra tutorials and sheet music. Or if you are watching on Facebook and I am pointing at nothing, you can find those things in the video description. I'll see you next time. Bye!